Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today I'm going to show you how to make a drink to toast the new year. It's going to be a beautiful drink. It's very easy to make. And the great thing about this drink is that you can just put them together one at a time or a couple and then put the ingredients back where they belong, either refrigerator or freezer, and get them out later and continue to make more drinks. This drink has fresh strawberries. And I bought 1 pound right here, and I've washed them and dried them with paper towel and put them back in this container. And I just wanted to show you, I have a little instrument here to take off the caps. If you have something like that, it makes things a little easier. But, of course, you could easily just use a knife if you want to. Either way. But when you get that, if you will do this in fourths, and then cut it in half. I think I'll put it over here. The size will be more manageable. And 1/4 cup is about what you would put in one of these drinks. So I have a lot here that I can go ahead and make more drinks, but I didn't really chop those up as fine. I just did quarters. But I think eighths will be better. So we'll come back to that. We also are going to use some pineapple sherbet, and I've had this sitting out just a bit so that it would be easy to remove. You don't want it to sit too long or it will just melt, but if you get it out of the freezer when it's brick hard, then it will be hard to scoop that into your stem glasses. And I've already started with one right here. I've got some pineapple sherbet. I did about 2.5 scoops. What you need to think of is that this would make about 8 drinks. Or you can stretch it. If you don't have much of this and you have more of other components, then just put what you like. Put the proportion that you like. And then the third component is going to be the liquid. And that can be alcoholic or not. You can use champagne. A lot of people like to use that on New Year's Eve. This happens to be a pink champagne. Use any kind of champagne that you like. Or you can substitute sparkling grape juice. And this is white grape juice. And this would be better than using the red for this drink because of the looks of the drink. So let's go ahead and assemble this one. I have my ice cream scoop in here, and it's kind of melted down, so these don't have to be pretty because we're just going to cover them with strawberries and pour the drink over the top, but we'll try to get a spoonful out of there. So when you have the amount of sherbet that you would like in your 2 stemmed glasses, then that's when you put your strawberries in. So I'm just going to pick this one and continue with it. Just sprinkle those over the top. And that will make a really pretty look. Actually, I picked some stem glasses that were decorated with Andy Warhol pictures of Marilyn Monroe. So maybe I should show you this side and you can see the actual look of the drink a little better. At this point, you pour your liquid in. So if you're using sparkling grape juice, then just go ahead and pour that in. And let it come up and it can foam at the top like that. And when you serve this, you probably want to have a spoon because we know there are strawberry bits in there, and they could be fairly large if we did the quarter sections. Also, there is some sherbet in there. So this is a really pretty drink. It's very showy. Actually, I recommend now a clear stemmed glass instead of one that is all painted up like this. But you can get the idea of it's going to look kind of murky at the bottom where we have the pineapple sherbet. And then there's going to be a line of strawberries that are cut. And then there's all this foam that is created by the either champagne or sparkling grape juice. And there you go. Cheers!